Sunday, 22:57, 48 seconds, year 2023, 10th month, October, 22nd day. And so, change the string on the dinky here. Dinky arch top. Come to find out that Allen wrench has to go on the back of these things here, loosen it. You got to cut the ball off. So these strings already had the balls cut off. Had to unloosen it down here, feed some more through, and then just tighten it down at the Allen wrench on the end down here. These things down here. Those things there, you got bolts on them down there at the end, so just tight, unloosen them, and then roll these things out, get some gappage in there, then unloosen them all, and retune it, get them fairly the same, and then dial them in with this afterwards. Stretch the string too before pulling it, so. Anyway, so there's the, I'm watching the recordings on TV that were put up. So I'm going to mess around with this some more. I'll use this other pick for now. Figure out where that other pick went. Hold on a second. I can tell already that I'm playing this guitar now for some time that these frets are here up here just aren't necessary because they don't sound good. They're not holding any resonance like these other ones. That's probably why they cut them off at 22 frets. 21, 22. Probably 21 has more resonance than 22. But 22 is resonant enough for me.
I think I'm gonna go outside.
just the regular string noise. And I've heard it said that the louder the guitar is for the string noise, the more sustained, the more overall it's gonna provide power and strength. See These Jackson pickups are strong, man. Nice bottom end punch. Pack a wallop. Fucking, it's just stuck up there on something. Anyway, I'm getting a lot of feedback out of this thing. It's probably the game. So I gotta figure out how to, you know, really control the feedback on this thing. Could be the presence. Oh, I had it on 100 watt, that's why. Alright. It was just me playing on this. It was just the camera. It was me just sitting here. There wasn't no playing. I think I'll pull these plastic things off. I cut the tag off. This is what it is. It's a Dinky Jackson Dinky arch top. And those are the specs. This guitar needs some getting used to because it's a fatter neck. I'm used to a skinnier neck. Strings are higher. I was gonna pick up. But it's resonant as hell. Fucking guitar is fucking resonant. The volume knobs are too tight to turn. They need to be quick turns. I like only three positions on the switch. I'm not into splitting them all up with five positions. These things are too close together. Keys, bump fingers and shit like that. But it doesn't matter anyway because the locks lock it all up. So these fuckers up as far as they'll go before they bottom out. That's the way I am. Gonna need some getting used to. 25 and a half to the edge of the bridge. So that's a half inch longer than a Les Paul.
See what this is. This one's like 22 and a quarter. And then the Ibanez is
5 3/4. Something like that. At least that's that. Tremolo guitars with a lock nut. When the strings are being popped.
Yes, Boob. Hi, Boob.
Might be too much grain. It might be the brown sound.
Mm-hmm.
adrenaline and excitement. So, you know, that's all. It's kind of neat. So Boobs is up here on the amp. She's enjoying herself. The invade pit.
Anyway, I get the screwdriver out of the way. There you go.
This thing here smells like weed inside. Kind of smells good in a way. Lost the pit. Thank you. with this Floyd Rose, it loosens the strings up like it's a Les Paul scale, like that one over there. They're nice and loose. That's what I really need. A full-size guitar that's nice and loose. And the tremolo. And the volume button's out of the way. The only thing is this right here. So I have to have that sculpted, or I shall sculpt it. Or I'll just get used to it or something. I cut the plate on the corner, like I did on one of those other ones. Cut it and then grind it down, and then snap the plate down, because it'll be cut, and so it'll just go at it now. So things to think upon. That's the E key here playing in. I'm satisfied so far with the sound that I have, but I just have to learn how to tweak it now to get it where I want it. I don't want to fuck with it anymore. I just want to keep it right where it's at for now, because at least I can have some satisfaction playing. Okay, so I'm probably hitting these. I can see I'm going to have to tape these fuckers. We'll put a thing of tape across, because I'm hitting these fuckers already. Off. I'm already scraping the fucking edge of the fucking arm all over that. Right there. I can just totally brown the fuck out of that. Four. 176. 4.
5, 1, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Notes all over the fucking place. I'm just throwing the hand, sliding it all over the fuck. I'm not worrying about where I'm going because I can always bend up to a note or bend down to a note if I want. I just quickly slide down. Because this is getting me to play somewhat much more efficiently than all these other guitars that I got around here. Is it the excitement in the air of new stuff, new amp, whatever the fuck it is? Who knows what it is? But it's that same feeling that I had when I got this piano. Except the piano was a stronger feeling for relaxation. This one was just a nice mellow, just trust you need to get this. But the breathing is coming in. I can feel the body, the flush in the skin around the skull and everything because all the extra oxygen is coming in now. And I've been missing oxygen since 2012 and went off electricity. I'm liking it already. I put myself in the hole to get it. But the Trump number came up in the bank account after it was all finished, so. That's the 145. There's the lotion. Oh. missing notes, but then that causes the melodies to change. So, and that's where I was at. I was really right there before these fingertips got cut. I was really right there, going off in different directions. So fucking nice. Neck seems to be, it's skinnier, it's narrower. It's not wide like the Ibanez neck. So, it's just something different. It's, God, man, I keep driving the fucking arm into that. That fucking sucks right there. Carlos Santana's figure was painted on the wall, and photographic print, big giant, like 15 foot tall across the whole wall, and Santana is holding up his Santana guitar, which I have played before at that store, and I love playing that guitar. That fucking thing is nice. Feels so fucking. But anyway, Santana is near the cash register. And then you got fucking, what's his name? Eric Clapton and one of the other guys. Stevie Ray Vaughan, that's right. Eric Clapton, then Stevie Ray Vaughan. And then B.B. King is right next to the lessons area. And then the Jimmy Page is on the other side of the lessons where the big opening is at for people to walk through. And then some fucking deep death metal guy with a white mask and a red guitar going down. And then Steve Vai is looking over at fucking Santana over at the other end with his glasses on. And then Randy Rhoads is leaning over at Steve. Steve's got his back to Randy and he's got his Jackson V. And his, you know, his white one that he custom made, and his eyes are closed. See if I can get a Dimebag Darrell going on here. We'll be right back. I can bend with the first finger because the strings are so nice and loose. I can do a lot of bending with this index finger.
Is it both of you?
It's just fair. So if I wanted to, I could get the bring the cord out here and see if I can hook this foot pedal up to this boss and see if I can get the MIDI to run that thing. I got to have acoustic at command. I got to be able to go back and forth between, or I'll just continue just fucking playing heavy metal and just burn out. Okay, let's see if I can get some light for this. It's on, so that's cool. Okay, I have to turn it on and then switch the amps off. Thing will function. I'll plug it in here, the MIDI cord. See if I can get this fucking thing to. See if I can get the amp to change channels. Something easily functioned. Okay, I got it to change, but now I gotta get it to get back to where it was. Figure out how to run it now. But something changed, so that was cool. Plug it, see what happens. Fuck, now I ain't got no fucking sound. Oh, well, I got it. There it is. You gotta plug it in. Ah, yeah. Whew, that was easy. Fuck yeah. That's a $100 pedal to get that effects pedal. This is MIDI, so it should be able to control every fucking thing on this thing. Five really gets it going. Down to clean. Fucking A. It just fucking hit just right. Yeah. That same thing with this thing is this switch here, the knobs and shit are all on the way. Make it nice and easy to. What's going on? They're behind. It's sitting behind. The switch is sitting behind the volume here, and then this arm just kind of gets in the way. Tone settings. It's on A or B, so it's hard to tell. I suppose if it's blinking, it's probably B. If it's not blinking, it's A. There's the red dot, and then there's over here is the tone shape. shape, global EQ, contour. And then this over here is the power control. And then this over here, this last one, it's hard to see, but it's the cab resonance. And it's all the way on deep. Put it back on too, and I lost what I had. So let me put it on panel. There it is. So I gotta hit panel is what does it. So now I gotta hit a preset here. Okay, so I got channel 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'm gonna set it to 3. So see what it does. Go to two. Go back to three. Ah, cool. Did exactly what common sense said it should have done. Exactly what common sense said it should have done. Now we're starting to fucking talk. Program volume into this thing. And I got you a wee-wee on the lap. So if I turn it up, all common sense tells me that if I hit 2 to program this on there, it should stay at that volume. So let's go back to it. Well, when I'm ready. Every time I see you. Okay, now I can get this going now.
The video the other day, it's got to have a straight line, be able to get to it. All right, plug it in.
Thank you.
so it looks like it's this volume all the way for the amplifier that's programmable. The master is not programmable. Might as well bring the water out. Bring the whole fucking thing out. Get my 64 ouncer. There it is. Valhalla Java. This is Valhalla Lemon, except it's already drank and it's just regular water now. Distilled. Sweet was a Randy Rhoads guy. I'll be damned. The second string just fucking popped out. It broke. Oh no, it's the first one. Oh my god, these fucking strings are fucking breaking. Could be that, oh well, we'll see. So now I gotta, only at 18 minutes into the jammy, so. Okay, so. Alright, so now I should be able to just hold on to this fucker and pull it out. Thank you. Jesus Christ, these things ain't coming out. Here we go. Get it down in there. So this thing's gonna get me used to, really used to plucking out fucking little pieces of sharp fucking metal. That's what these things fucking leave behind. Okay, so I just have to loosen it up there. Loosen it up here. Seems like it's traveling. Yeah, so righty-tighty actually loosens the string.
Tell this is gonna be a bunch of shit. May have to get some more of these little fucking squares, these little fucking things pop out. I need a magnet. Let go of it. Now all the fucking tension got let out of it. Okay, so I have to sit here and figure out how these fuckers go in here. Oh, it looks like it goes for the screw, a spot for the screw hole. See, this has got a little fucking hole in it. See the little hole?
hole. There it is. So it looks like that probably goes down to the screw. Have the solid block that blocks it there. So it probably goes in this way. Yeah, that's what it looks like. This goes in. I'm not too thrilled at how this shit goes together. Not too thrilled at this at all. Not at all. I'm already thinking a way to just put the whole fucker in there with the ball, tie the bowl off and put the whole fucking ball. It looks like there's gonna be room. Might wanna bend it and crimp it. That'll give it a little something extra to bite onto. That'll probably gotta be a fucking surgeon to put this fucker back together. Too tight with it, just enough. So that should be enough. Now I should be able to start going the other way and tighten it all the way up. Do the Tony Iommi stretch. I was already stretching them like this, and then when I saw Tony stretching them like this, I says, "Oh yeah, it's the only way to really stretch it that's sensible." That fucking shit up. So, you should be tight. This is a Jackson Bridge by Floyd Rose.
kind of tight. Alright, so there's that. Just back there. I might as well see how I'm up. Oh, that's 1 hour 30 minutes into the video. Alright, later.